of 107 million single Americans this Sunday. Could be your lucky day. All right, so according to Match, it's online dating's busiest day of the year for some unknown reason. It's called their Super Bowl Sunday for Love. Diane Macedo is here with some ways to stand out from the crowd. What is it about this Sunday?
I guess people are kicking off the new year as hopeful romantics, but this Sunday, Match expects to see a 42% spike in signups. But registering for a dating site is just the beginning. So we set out to find out how to make the most of your online search for love.
I'm Christy, I'm 31, and I'm looking for love.
Celebrity stylist Christy Jorfeld spent her 20s focused on her work, but now she's ready to ring in 2018 with romance.
I would love to find someone that is independent, self-motivated.
According to Match, Christy's chances of getting a date are 4 times higher if she joins a site or app.
We see over 50 million messages exchanged, 5 million photos uploaded, and over 1 million dates generated.
Christy enlists the help of Bela Gandhi from Smart Dating Academy. Think of her as a fairy godmother for hire.
Dating is a marathon, it's not a sprint, so you've got to get up and do something on a daily basis.
She says join only 1 or 2 sites and make sure they're age appropriate.
If you're in your 20s, Bumble is my favorite at this point. When you're in your 30s and 40s, Match is one of our favorite sites. Our time is dedicated to singles over 50, and eHarmony is also great for those age brackets.
90% of online dating success is based on photos.
I think that replacing these 3 photos is going to make a big difference. Show you doing things that you really like to do. Those all make for great photos.
But don't move too fast. Gandhi suggests speaking by phone before you meet in person and keep your number private with Google Voice. It creates an alternative phone number that can be erased at any time.
You can tell so much about someone. You can separate their cyber personality from their real personality.
But don't be too much of a skeptic. Bella says look at online love with what she calls psychotic optimism.
It means love will come to me. It's a when, it's not an if. I am in it to win it.
With that advice, Christy's finally putting herself out there.
She's helped me come out of my comfort zone and get back into dating.
Psychotic optimism. There we go. Some other things Bella says we should keep in mind. Don't have a next day delivery mindset. Just because you get online doesn't mean the perfect person is going to arrive in your mailbox within 48 hours. Be patient. Secondly, don't date someone who gives you butterflies. This is surprising, but she says butterflies are usually your gut telling you something is wrong. It's your fear and anxiety, not your excitement.
No.
Just the messenger. I'm just the messenger here. The other thing she says, and I think we can all agree with this one, do find a high GHQ man. That's high in good husband qualities.
And what are those?
That means kindness, reliability, loyalty, integrity, and supportiveness. And my own suggestion, embrace the mishaps. They make for really funny stories, don't they?
Yeah, embrace the butterflies. It's okay.
All right, I guess the butterflies are okay. I don't know.
Yeah, just get them all to fly in formation.
Just the right kind of butterflies.
Yeah. Oh, now we have to differentiate the butterflies.
I'll go back.
This is a lot.
I will go back and come back with a full report.
But it's this Sunday at 8:55 p.m. They have it down to the exact time.
That is the time.
You guys in?
Everybody's looking for love. Who's in?
Diane, thanks so much. We appreciate it. Okay, we have a